Republican Congressman Ken Buck made headlines by announcing his early retirement last week. In his announcement, he blamed the fact that Congress has become completely dysfunctional. And he said he just couldn't be a part of it anymore. It was pretty telling. I mean, we've known this. You and I have talked about how dysfunctional it is. Nothing ever happens. But can you imagine taking your life? Okay, you're saying, okay, I'm going to be away from my family for months at a time. I'm going to be dealing with this problem for months at a time, knowing there's really never going to be a resolution. That's basically what he said.
Yeah, and it is very telling because we're having more and more lawmakers on both sides that have come out just in the last month or two saying, we're not doing anything. Mm-hmm. I mean, look at what's happening right now. We've still got another budget battle, which means this is the fifth time in 10 months we've been right at the precipice of a government shutdown. Mm-hmm. We can't even get the budgets passed. They're just kicking the can down the road each time, another month or two, five near government shutdowns in 10 months.
Buck is not the first one. You understand, probably in the last year and a half, there's been three or four of these folks, and they've all had the same story. Why am I wasting my life? That's the headline. Why am I wasting my life in Washington, D.C. with these numbnuts that really don't want anything to move, right?
Well, and it is so frustrating because these people should be leaving D.C. saying, wow, I made a difference. I'm proud of my body of work.
Yeah.
Instead, they're literally giving up because they look at the people around them and it's filled with freaks. Let's be real. We have too many freaks in Congress. And they look at these people and they say, this is a damn circus. What am I even doing here? And Ken Buck even said, I think this place is dysfunctional. To me, it's important to get in the mix of this election cycle and start talking about the issues that people recognize are such a problem right now. So he says, I'm going to go and I'm going to work for an outside organization.
Yeah.
Now, I'm willing to bet that outside organization probably offered a pretty big paycheck.
No doubt.
But at the same time, at least he's saying...
like something like lobbying.
Yeah, he's saying, look... I know we're not doing anything. I know there are important issues that do need action, and I'm going to leave. Whether or not he actually does it is one thing, but what he's saying is true.
I think it's funny. Over the years, I know you've been asked, Farron, why don't you run for politics? Why don't you run? The truth is, you accomplish so much more by doing what you do every single day.
Yeah.
Dirty money flow through its branches around the world, including at least 800...
Plaintiffs allege that the defendants provided money and medical goods to terrorist groups Hezbollah and Jaish al-Mahdi.
This is a well-organized business for these individuals that carry out these attacks. Terrorism is a business, and they run it like a business.
They knew about what was going on for a decade. They absolutely, no question about it, knew that HSBC was washing money. They had every reason to understand it was for terrorism and it was for drug cartels. Took no action whatsoever.
These banks are involved. Their accounts are connected and they're using them to mask the transactions. The more complicated they can make the transactions, the more distance they can put between the bad guys and the seemingly legitimate purpose of these funds.
They pay $1.9 billion, which is a drop in the bucket compared to what they've made. And nobody goes to prison. These CEOs, these bankers that made this decision, they're safe at home. They know what they've done. It's resulted in the death of Americans, contractors and soldiers, not just hundreds, but thousands. And we look the other way because they don't look like criminals. The die is cast. The people that are responsible for are on Wall Street.
And they don't look like criminals. It's almost a suspension of disbelief. Sometimes I'll have people call me and say, is this real? Do they really get away with this? Yeah, they do.